Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Friday, September 23rd, 2011. This is a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York morning session. First, let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations, but we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. And we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a weekly chart without indicators for the Euro-USD currency pair as that chart looked at the end of last week on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform. I've got this chart zoomed out to show price action since early November of last year. Now I want to draw your attention to the lower left-hand portion of this chart. Notice the highs identified here by red arrows all established before the end of 2010 and also the February low identified with blue arrow here. All four of those highs and the February low are within just 10 pips of the 1.3430 level. So it seems that the 1.3430 area was important several months ago, and given the recent sell-off on the euro, that area might come into play soon. Let's add a horizontal blue line at 1.3430. You'll see that blue line at 1.3430 again later on another euro chart. For now, let's take a look at DAX futures. The DAX is Germany's blue chip stock market index. This view shows two charts for the DAX futures front month contract. On the left is a daily chart showing price action through yesterday's close, and on the right is a 15-minute chart showing price action from today's London open up to 8 a.m. New York time. Back on the daily chart, note how DAX futures dropped sharply. You see the sharp drop there in early August, then slid more gradually down until ultimately finding support at 5,000 early last week. Today, another round of selling started at London Open has taken DAX futures back down to that same 5,000 level. There's a couple recent bounces at 5,000. Now, this is interesting because we've seen a pretty solid correlation between DAX futures and the euro during recent New York morning sessions. Today, you have a roughly 90% correlation between DAX futures and the euro-USD based on 5-minute closing prices since the London Open. Now, you don't have to be a so-called quant to figure that out, though. During my live coaching session, I showed a chart overlaying DAX futures and the euro-USD with an overlay chart function for the MT4 platform that anyone can use. So as of 8 a.m. Eastern time, the open of New York session on the last trading day of the week, you've got DAX futures basically sitting right at 5,000. Let's take a look at a couple of euro pairs to see where they stand at this time. On the left is a 15-minute chart for the EURUSD. On the right, a 15-minute chart for the EURYEN, as both charts looked at 8 a.m. New York time today. Now, remember that 1.3430 level I mentioned earlier on the weekly chart? Well, the euro is there. The euro is there, horizontal blue line at 3430. And just below that is a weekly M1 pivot point represented by a horizontal green line near the bottom of that chart. That's another prospective source of support for the euro. Moving now to the EURYEN chart, this pair printed a new 10-year low in the 102.25 area during yesterday's New York morning session. Today, this pair has been moving down in lockstep with the EURUSD, and as of 8 a.m. New York time, the EURYEN sits a mere 15 pips above, actually a little less than 15 pips above that 102.25 level, which seemed to define yesterday's low. So DAX futures at 5,000, a prospective support level, EURUSD near a weekly M1 pivot point, plus a level which was important for several weeks late last year, and a potential double bottom on the euro-yen. If you thought that Europe was generally oversold, at least for the time being, this was go time soon after the open of the New York session. Let's see what these two pairs did over the next 4 hours. The London close is represented by a red vertical line on the right-hand side of each of these two charts. Euro-USD rose up about 125 pips from its New York morning low, while the Euro-Yen rose a bit more than 100 pips up. Although both pairs failed to match London morning highs, if you took a long on one of those pairs and stuck with it through the first 3 hours of the New York session, you caught the majority of today's euro recovery against the dollar or the yen. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video review from fxbootcamp.com for Friday, September 23rd.